Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Capsa. Today's topic is about genomic organization of E. coli or genomic structure of E. coli. So the genome of Escherichia coli bacteria is organized in a circular DNA molecule. How? The shape is circular, that is packed within a cellular nucleoid. Okay. So this type of nucleoid made up of DNA, protein and RNA. DNA is near about 80%, RNA is 10% and protein is 10%. Okay. So the size of this genome varies from 4.5 to 5.5 MB. Okay. So obviously to study the genomic structure, E. coli K12 strain is taken or was studied, and MG1655, this is the name of the genome of this strain, was studied, whose sequence was studied. After studying, it was observed that 12 chromatin proteins were found in E. coli. Among them, 5 only exist in abundant concentration, means 20,000 copies per cell, and 4 of them are well characterized. So these 4 are HU, IHF, HNS and FIS protein. Okay. Now this is the picture of single circular E. coli genome. Second picture represents the random supercoiling structure of the DNA of E. coli, and after incorporation into the cell, how the genome looks like. Okay, this image represents this. So this picture represents bidirectional replication means two directional. First direction here, right part. This is left part, second directional, bidirectional. This is the terminal part and this is the origin part. This part NS represents non-structural part. It means this part does not participate in the DNA replication process. And green, red, blue, sky, these colors actually represents these proteins. Which kind of proteins? HU, IHF, HNS, FIS proteins. Okay. So after supercoiling, the structure looks like this, and after incorporation into the cell, the picture is like this. This is a daughter E. coli cell. Okay. Now we will study about the individual protein. So HU represents the heat unstable. Protein. Okay, so this protein actually exists as homodimer in most of the bacteria, but in case of E. coli or enterobacteriaceae bacteria, it actually forms heterodimer. So this protein forms heterodimer, which consists of two subunits, HU alpha and HU beta. These two subunits again encoded by two genes. So HUPA gene and HUPB gene. Okay, and plays a important role in DNA compaction, DNA replication, transcription, recombination, etc. Now we will understand about another kind of protein, that is IHF protein. So IHF actually represents integration host factor. Okay, it means this kind of protein, when binds with the DNA, induces a large bend up to 180 degree. Okay, 180 degree bending. So it is a small heterodimeric protein which consists of again two subunits, IHFA, IHFB, and shows some properties like sequence specific, histone like, multifunctional, DNA binding and bending. Okay, bending up to 180 degrees Celsius, mind it. Okay. So this protein plays a vital role in DNA bending, which is necessary for long range interaction. How long range interaction? I will say later. Also helps in genetic recombination as well as transcriptional. Genetic recombination and transcription and translational process. Now these two subunits, one of these two subunits of IHF actually plays a crucial role in lysogenic life cycle. What it plays? Lysogenic life cycle of bacteriophage lambda. Okay. And in this life cycle, for the genetic recombination reactions, for incorporation or insertion of lambda DNA into chromosomes, and also for the synthesis of two repressor protein. Two repressor proteins are INT and CL. These are the two repressor protein. These two repression proteins are synthesized with the help of one of these two subunits. It means this two, one of these two subunits needs for the synthesis of these two kind of repressor protein for the DNA insertion and repression respectively. So for two purpose, in the lysogenic life cycle of bacteriophage lambda, for the genetic recombination and for the incorporation of lambda DNA into chromosomes, and for the synthesis of INT and CL, these two kind of repressor protein. Okay. Now, what is HNS? So, HNS is represent as histone-like nucleoid structuring heat stable protein. Okay. So this is a kind of NAP or nucleoid associated protein which regulates 60% of the E. coli genes, and this protein plays a vital role in DNA condensation and act as a key regulator of gene expression in response to changes in osmolarity, pH and temperature. It means it can regulate the gene expression in response to external factors such as osmolarity, pH and temperature. Okay. Another protein is, fourth protein is FIS protein. So FIS actually stands for factor for inversion and stimulation. Factor for inversion stimulation protein. So it is a small NAP or nucleoid associated protein which actually has a alpha helical core of 4 helices named A to D, 4 type of helix A to D. Okay. So this protein has 2 terminals, N terminals, C terminals. N terminal domain has a helix and flexible beta hairpin like arm, and C terminal domain has a C and D helices. Okay. This N terminal part actually takes part in DNA inversion process. Okay. And this protein plays a vital role in organization and maintenance of the nucleoid structure through the bending process, DNA bending process. Also, directly modulates several cellular responses or processes like transcription, chromosomal replication, DNA inversion, integration, phage integration, etc. Now, this is the picture which represents the 4 kind of protein interaction. First picture actually normal eukaryotic chromosomal folding represents. Second picture represents how HNS participate in the formation of DNA loops by changing in the temperature and osmolarity. And third picture, which is represents structural maintenance of chromosomes by forming SMC complex. SMC full form is structural maintenance chromosomal complexes. And fourth one is represent FIS protein induces DNA bending. This DNA bending is up to 50 to 60 degree angular bending. Okay. And last picture represents how IHF and HU protein helps in DNA bending up to 160 degree angle. Okay. And you need to keep in mind important things is another kind of protein, which is DPS type of protein, which highly abundant protein also found in E. coli, but during the stationary phase, because the HU and FIS protein actually replaced by DPS protein during the stationary phase, because this protein required for normal starvation response and long-term stationary phase viability. For this purpose, this protein is required. So this is the genomic organization of structure of E. coli. This is the end of my lecture. If you like my video, please do like, comment, share and subscribe. Thank you for your attention.